we got a little visitor here today, little Miss Rosie. She's checking out the shop, looking for little bits. Gonna finish off some beavers there. Take these ones off the board. Went out for a little elk hunt this morning with Blake. It was pretty quiet, seen a couple deer, but not much was moving, nice and quiet, calm, and then the wind came up. And yeah, so we'll have to try that again later. But we've got stuff to do today. Big long list of stuff for trapping that we got to do, but haven't been able to get the time. I'd take a couple days off here and just bang it all away and get all that stuff behind me and have a good season. But we'll do some flushing here. So what we'll do is take the beavers off the boards first and then skin, I guess. Wiping them up, they're nice and dry. Not much grease on there. Looks good. So what I like to do is, some people take a block of wood, put it on. I like to just pull them off the nails from before. Kind of give you an example of that. So I just use a nail head before, and I usually like to start at the head or the base, just because that's a little bit thicker leather. And when you start pulling, you want to come back to it. If you start like halfway through, it doesn't pull that good. Start here. You don't have to go in too far, just enough so that they're a bit snug. Sometimes they go up a little bit wet.
damp. So I just had to go against the lay of the fur, get it fluffed up. Get it looking nice, and then I go with the drain. Shake and all are good. Like I said, they're usually not in that far, especially the leg ones, just enough to hold it. Just the heads, the head and the tail where it's a little bit thicker, the rest fairly loose. And get started over here and work the way around again. Brush again. This one's a little bit better. Oh, the other one was rubbed up in the shoulders a little bit. So there's a later spring beaver. Nice and prime.
another one done. Let's see what we got here. These have been thawed out in the fridge there for a couple days. large, rough skinned. So I'll start at the nose, work my way down. I'm gonna use my two-handed flusher today. Here's the ear butts, the eyes. And I just kind of start back by the eyes, get underneath the membrane there, run that up towards the ears, get to the ear butts and just cut through them. The other side of the ears, kind of get underneath that membrane again. Get it rolling, rolling and shaving. Touch her up if it needs it. I like to go down the back where it's most gristly and attached, and then shave it off after from the sides. Once you get about halfway, you can go a little wider, but then you start to chase it a little bit. So my beam's not all that wide. But I'll get this part here too, I guess. Bring her back up and work my way down. Right there, there's, it's pretty much attached right to the hide, so it takes a little bit of work to get it. The fatter the beaver it is, the better, or easier it flushes. So this one was a spring beaver. Not all that fat. So it's a little bit tougher. What I showed you before is you can also do this with a knife. Shave her down like that. Past the gristly part. You can use a knife to do this part too. I can show you, I guess. Feel it right, just clean your blade off. Then it's just like peeling a carrot. Just get it started and roll it off. If I was going to use the flushing knife, here it's still gristly, so I can just do the same thing. A little bit of a slicing motion. And just ride it off to the end of the pelt.
had done this piece already with the knife. So I just have the last little bit here to do with the two-handed flesher. So that's pretty much done down the back, down the center. I can clean this piece up. I was just showing you a couple things, so I'll touch that up now. Normally I do it all in one shot. So pull your eye tight and coming up to the leg there, so you gotta be careful not to get a wrinkle. This side down. Okay, so then once I get the middle done, go back to the face. Usually just push that cheek off and I can work from there down towards the tail. Push that off. And I trim all that off anyways. So the front leg to the corner of the mouth, it's got some glands and stuff there. That's what we're just shaving off now. Okay, we got that cleaned up. So now, clean that off so I'll get that. And I'm just gonna take my fleshing, two-handed flesher, and just kind of start the top of the leg. It stays. Push right down, because this is all loose fat. So that'll come off good. Start to tear the leg. And for this part, because it's thinner and easier to come off, I just used my dollar side. The other stuff I was using my sharp side. So now I can just push it off. Watch for nipples. Let's see, get a good part ways down there. Just give her a scrape and we'll pull her up. Keeping the edge clean, not rolling on the fur, just kind of grabbing it and pulling it on. The back leg in here somewhere, so I'm just gonna watch for it to ball up and then pop over it just like that. Tune the edge up and push her up. Over to the other side. Start the front leg again. Bristle there, kind of hold it on, push that off. Again, watch for nipples. And then push it off to the back leg there. This one's ready for the board. We'll do another one here real quick. Yeah, another rough skin beaver. Time we'll try it with the knife. See what happens. Face is pretty clean from when we skinned it. Just finding the right pressure and angle. Let that down. Gonna go a little wider here. our rudder down to the end. Little bite mark right there, so just try and be careful. Sometimes it goes better with a knife, and sometimes it goes better with the two-handed flusher. So I could go back, use the two-handed flasher, but we'll kind of do it here with the knife. Yeah, it's clean enough. Like that. Now I'll just use my flasher to do the lips and then work down the sides. Okay, spin it around. kind of working underneath that membrane here, spreeing it up around the leg. Over it. Once I get over it, I can clean it up a bit on the back side. Grab the leg there and start to open it up. Almost started the tear there. And there we go, we got another one all done. Now we'll grab one more and see what we got here. This one's still frozen. Save that for another day. Again, start at the back of the eyes. Take the earbud off. A one's a little gristlier. So I'm gonna use the knife here for a little bit just to get past. Couple spots. Never been able to get it over my knee. Maybe it's because I twist funny or whatever, but. The way it works not too bad for me. So, a little bit gristly here, but this is where it was worse. So we'll go back to our two-handed flesher here. That happened because there was a bit of a burr in my flushing beam, I think, right there. I was getting a little overconfident. This looks worse than it is. Just a little hole there, but I'll nail that closed. Just being careful around it, just let him open it up some more. Okay. Couple of hangers. Thank you. We're going a bit of a reverse order, I guess, but now I'm gonna board this after I fleshed it. So when you skin it, you're gonna have a kind of like a little flap on each end here, and then on the nose, you're gonna have your lips that stick out. So we're gonna grab between the nose and the eyes about halfway and pinch with my thumb and forefinger. And I'm gonna line up on the rings on my board. So just kind of so it's snug, so then I know that's the max I can go. So then you go two rings from there, and I'm gonna be right there. So kind of a large, medium beaver. Take out the nails. And just double check where I'm at. So I can go to the outer ring, come in too, and right there. I'm gonna tap the tail and the nose. Try and get it all centered. Again, you don't have to drive your nail way in. And I just kind of pull this until I feel it's good and centered. Because if I had too much up here and not enough slack down here when I finish boarding, it's going to be uncomfortable there. Have to pull and reef and all that good stuff. Again, make sure you're on the right line. And then I just start quartering it from here. Keeping this tight, giving a bit more slack up here. I can almost go in one ring, but you can make this work. Once we go here, I like to do the back and the lips and then the sides last. So I'll kind of work that order here. Just so I know I get really good. Here's those extra flaps. So I just put a bit past there. And I'm not going to nail every inch yet. I'm just kind of getting it formed. So I have an idea with what I'm working with, and then I'll go in and close it all off here after. So in a gap like this, I'll split the difference in the middle and put a nail on each side of that, and then come back later and there's one between each of those. Edges were clean from when I did it on the beam. So as I'm going through, I'm looking, make sure there's no fat along the edge. It's gonna be a little bit of fat by the arms. As I can, I'm gonna trim and clean that up after. I'm gonna give it a quick little scrape there with the kind of little knife thing I have. Again, we're going to trim all the lips off here. Bearing on the hide, and pulled off there. You want to go in about an eighth of an inch. This one is a little tight, or a little short on that. So you can see it's starting to get fairly tight there. Like I said, I could have probably went one ring less, but we can get it there. I can feel it. A bit more more slack here, I could move that over here. So now I have that there, I'll go through, but I got it fairly tight. I'm just gonna give it a quick scrape. Just this little scraper here. Just taking the last little bit of meat off, if there is any. A little bit of grease. Trim the legs up a little bit. A dull knife, that one. Just a little membrane needs cleaning up there. There's the tail. I'm just gonna trim that. Here to the ears. Clean that up. A little bit of membrane here I missed. Clean this leg up. And then trim the nose. I like to split right down the middle. Chop the lip there, and boom, done. So I'll finish nailing this out and do the legs as I go. And you always want to make sure you lift up your belt. There you go. How she is.